party actually began at sunup when long lines began forming outside the Pimlico entrance gates. By 8:30, the crowd was ready.
Come here, it's 6:30.
How come?
We were going to bring this. I gotta get away. We're gonna be late.
And with that, the rush was on through the $7 ticket windows and then the tunnel that leads to the infield. For the first time, kegs were not allowed or push carts to make this job easier. But then again, necessity is the mother of invention. The early birds got to rope off their areas alongside the fence. That way, they could see the show on both sides of them.
This is pretty prime real estate here at Pimlico. How'd you get it?
How'd we get it? We ran. And first in line.
Miss Preakness, Katrina Owens, gave her blessing.
This is just one big party.
And the curtain rose.
Is that good a party? Is of course. It's a great time. It's like going to a concert. And then we're watching horses instead of a band.
Horses?
Horses.
Look around. You see any horses?
Well, I see a lot of nice...
You have a lot of nerve.
I know, but what can you say?
Everyone around here says the Orioles will sooner or later catch up to the Tigers. What do you say about that?
It's the Tigers here.
Where's the beef? Look around behind you. You just answered your own question.
Yeah, where's the beef?
No, not us.
Why not?
We aren't interested.
How many people come up to you and ask you for a mint julep instead of a black-eyed Susan?
About 300. 300 people.
What do you tell them?
I tell them, black-eyed Susan.
The sun pretty good, is it?
Yeah, it's fantastic today.
You're going to feel like at 5 o'clock.
I'm going to feel just fine.
With the possible exception of another World Series championship, this is just about the year's best party in Baltimore. And despite the changes that have been made this year, it's pretty obvious that tradition has been preserved here at the 1984 Preakness. At Pimlico, Tom Sinkovitz, Action News 11.